must have the bonds on it. He's up in there somewhere. Come on.
Hasn't got a thing on him.
Looks like he was too smart for us, Brainard.
Yeah. I thought it was funny him wanting to hang on to them bonds.
Could he have sold them without us knowing it?
No, not a chance. The only time Martin's been alone since we stuck up the train is when he was in bed.
Then he must have hidden them someplace around that ranch.
Maybe you're right. Come on, let's get going.
Washout.
I still think the bombs are in the house.
No, I've been over that place with a fine-tooth comb. The only thing I found was the map with the directions to dig here.
Yeah, it must be a phony.
Well, there's no use quitting until we find out.
Martin wouldn't bury the stuff that deep.
Oh, there's no telling what he'd do.
You boys digging for fish worms?
Oh, don't shoot, mister. I ain't no game warden. You can fish if you want to. I won't bother you.
Who are you?
Jack Benson. They call me Magpie.
Silly name, ain't it?
What do you want?
The guns make me nervous. Thanks, pal. Looking for a job.
Anybody send you here?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, I don't want to tell.
I'm giving you just 2 seconds to talk.
Oh, the old lady. She told me if I didn't get a job, she'd just beat the tar out of me.
Yeah, well, you're due for a larrupin.
Oh, mister, have a heart.
Run him off the place, Luke. And if he hangs back, throw some lead in his heels.
Well, I'd sooner fight it out the old lady than stay here with you guys, believe me.
Start moving.
If you fellas ain't digging for fish worms, what are you digging for?
Exercise.
Well.
having trouble, miss?
Yes. Where can I get some water?
Got a canteen right on the saddle there.
Oh,
you know, water's a pretty handy thing to carry in this part of the country.
It certainly is.
Hey, I thought you were the one dying of thirst.
I am. But I can hold out till I reach Lone Jack. The car can't.
You heading for Lone Jack?
Yes.
What are you doing on this road? You could have stayed on that paved road 2 miles back there.
Well, I came this way because I wanted to take a look at... Oh, it isn't important. Thank you.
Well, don't think I was trying to pry into your business, Miss Martin.
How did you know my name?
Just read it on the registration card.
Oh, it's too bad they don't tag horses that way, isn't it?
I'm sorry. My name is Brown.
Oh?
Now, you don't happen to be any relation to old Ben Martin, do you?
Well, who is Ben Martin?
He's an old fellow who used to live down the road here a couple of miles. He was killed a short time ago. People around here thought he had something to do with that big robbery that was pulled a while back.
Oh, I see. And because my name is the same as his, you think I'm related to him. Thank you.
Well, just a coincidence. Must be what?
Did you see him there?
Why, nothing. I was just looking in.
So what do you want here?
Well, you see, I'm interested in abandoned farms and ranches and...
Well, this is a good ranch not to be interested in.
Well, I don't see that that's any of your business.
Lady, this place ain't a healthy one to hang around. It's haunted.
Well, I don't believe in ghosts.
That's just a polite way of telling you to get into your gas buggy and put as many miles between you and here as you can. Understand?
In trouble again, Miss Martin?
Brown's the name. Sam Brown. Now, you clear out of here. You heard me.
Sudden, aren't you?
Huh? Oh, well, that's my name, Sudden Sam Brown.
Oh.
Who was that fella?
I don't know.
Well, he gave you some pretty good advice.
What do you mean?
About staying away from this place. It might be dangerous.
Well, I may as well tell you what I told him. I don't believe in ghosts.
Neither do I. But when a fella like Ben Martin dies the way he did, he's apt to leave a trail of danger behind him. Just bear that in mind, young lady.
You say he called her Miss Martin?
Yeah.
Say, wonder if Martin could have told that girl where to get those bonds. Say, maybe you've got something there, Slade. You should have held on to her.
Well, that fella Brown was too fast for me. I had my gun out, but he winged me before I could pull the trigger.
Well, there's no use crying over spilled milk. I'll hightail it into town and see if I can get an option on the Martin place from the sheriff. One of you keep an eye on that Martin girl.
Okay.
I'd like to accommodate you, Brown, but it's impossible.
Well, what about getting an option on the place for a couple of weeks?
No.
Suppose that paper told against it.
Too late for that now. Sale goes on as advertised tomorrow.
Well, in that case, there's nothing for me to do but try to bid it in, eh?
Oh, you won't have much competition. That ranch has sort of got a bad reputation.
I've heard about that. The ghost of Ben Martin is supposed to haunt it or something like that, isn't it? Oh, good morning, Miss Martin. We seem to be following each other around, don't we?
I don't think so.
Good afternoon, young lady.
Sheriff Long?
That's right. Sit down.
I'm interested in the Ben Martin Ranch.
Yeah? What about it?
Well, if the debt against it isn't too much, I'd like to pay it.
Well, you were the second one that wanted to do that today.
Who else wanted to? The man who just left here?
That's right. A fellow by the name of Brown, Sam Brown. And I told him the same thing as I'm going to have to tell you.
What's that?
At the highest bidder at the auction tomorrow gets the whole shebang, lock, stock, and barrel.
Well, I'm afraid that lets me out. I haven't enough money to buy it.
Well, I'm sorry, but that's the best I can do.
Thanks, Sheriff.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Howdy, Brainard.
Hi, Sheriff. Have a cigar?
Well, don't care for noon.
Say, I was thinking about that Martin place. You know, it joins my ranch at the back, and I thought that maybe I could...
Say, what's this all about? There's been three of you in here in as many minutes wanting to buy that place. I even think it was full of gold.
Who got it?
Nobody. I ought to get a good price for that place with all of you interested. Especially those other two being strangers.
Well, maybe you and me could make a deal.
No.
Come on, Ed. Give me an option on the place. Postpone the sale for a week. It'll be easy money, Ed.
No can do, Brainard.
That's what that fella Brown wanted. Brown? You say Brown?
Yeah. Sam Brown. And if I don't miss my guess, he'll give you plenty of competition.
Yeah. Thanks for the tip. I'll see that he doesn't.
Hello, Mike. Bye.
Well, I just about to give you up. I didn't think you'd go to jail.
Well, I got here as quick as I could. What's been happening?
Let's get under cover.
One of your grave diggers?
Yeah, he's a big moose of the outfit.
That's what I thought. Now, that Martin Ranch is going under the hammer tomorrow. You lay low till after that sale.
Brainard! Just
yeah?
A minute. I've got something in here that'll interest you.
Well, look, I'm in a hurry. I don't want to take much time.
Oh, my! Keep your hand away from that gun. Now get up to your feet. Hand me that gun.
You can't get away with this.
Well, I seem to be.
All right, folks, we better get started.
Say, can't you hold off a minute, Sheriff? Brainard ain't here yet.
10 o'clock's the time, and that's what it is now. Sale goes on as advertised. Now, you all know this ranch, and those of you that don't have had plenty of time to look it over. Everything is included. Buildings, land, machinery, and livestock of any. Now, who's going to start the ball rolling? Who'll give me the first bid?
$500.
All right, anything to get underway. Now, who'll make it $1,000? What's the matter? You all tongue-tied? You know this ranch is worth at least $5,000. Come on, speak up.
$600.
$600 I'm bid. Now, who'll make it $700?
Seven.
$700 it is. I bid $700, now the $800.
Who'll give me the eight?
I hate to do this to you, Brainard, but you're apt to get in my way.
$1,700 I'm bid for this plate. $1,700 once. $1,700 twice.
$1,800.
Well, that's better. Now, who will make it $1,900?
Do I hear the $2,000?
Do I hear $2,000?
$2,000.
Ah, that's it. That's better. Competition makes the world go round. I'm bid $2,000. Now, do I hear the $2,100? Who's going to give us the 21? Well, now, it's no skin off of my nose, but I call it a highway robbery to sell this place for
$2,100.
$2,100 I'm bid. Now, the 22.
22. How about it, Slade?
23. Are you all through?
23.
25.
$2,600, Slade?
I'm finished.
$2,500 I'm bid. Going at $2,500 once, $2,500 twice, third and last call, and sold to Mr. Brown here for $2,500.
By the way, you'll find your friend Brainard down at the barn. I think he needs a little help.
You'll find everything in apple pie order.
You made about as good a job of hiding that money as you did of grabbing it, didn't you? Looking for someone?
Put your hands up, quick.
Why, it's a girl. I can get a look at you, sister. Well, if it isn't Miss Martin. What is this, a holdup? Because if it is, you're a little late for my money. I paid it all off for this ranch today.
Why did you buy this place?
I bought it because I liked it. Now, just what are you after?
Well, I may as well tell you. You're right about my being related to Ben Martin. He was my uncle. But I didn't know anything about him. He wrote Mother, though, that picture was very valuable.
That one? Doesn't look very valuable, does it?
No, I guess I made a fool of myself.
Well, now, maybe not, you know. Tell her what we could do. We could have it valued, and if you still want it, why, maybe we can make a deal.
Thank you. I guess I'd better go now. I left the car down the road.
I'll go along with you, if you don't mind.
Thank you.
What are you doing here at this time of the night?
Listen, I was just down at that Martin place. They're both inside, Brown and the girl. And they're talking about that painting of old Ben that hangs on the wall. The girl said Ben wrote the picture was worth a lot of money.
That's it? The picture. When you searched that house, did you look that picture over well?
No. I didn't see how they could hide anything in that.
Well, if he left any directions as to where he hid the bonds, that's just where he left them. Come on inside.
I'll go down and sound him out. You wait here and don't let anybody see you. No hard feelings, Brown. Everything's fair in love and war.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about it.
You know, I meant to buy this place. You beat me to it.
Well, I was afraid of competition.
Would you care to sell? Not a fair price.
Well...
Name Brown?
Yes, I'm Brown.
I'm sure glad of that. I begged this fellow for a job and he turned me down. Sheriff said you want to hire a hand.
Well, I guess maybe I could use you. Go out to the house. I'll talk to you later.
Thanks, pal.
You were saying you'd like to buy this place?
Yeah. What'll you take for it?
Oh, about half a million.
Half a million?
Well, I figure I ought to get about that much out of it.
Oh, you mean you don't want to sell?
Well, not exactly. Not just yet, anyway. I want to see how things work out.
I see. Well, I'll be dropping in again sometime.
Do, I'll be always glad to see you.
They've grown them already.
They didn't waste much time, did they?
Did you have a chance to look around?
I looked through that barn pretty thoroughly, but there's nothing in there.
Martin was too smart. He wouldn't hide them bonds where he couldn't get to them in a hurry.
Well, you look through everything in the house. Tear all the furniture apart if you have to. But we've got to find those bonds.
Leave it to me. I'm the best little searcher in the world.
Brown knows that stuff is hidden on the ranch. Now, either he's working with the girl to get it, or he's the law.
The law? You mean to say...
I don't know what to think. But here's what we've got to do. I'm going to see Slade. Now, you ride into town and watch the girl. And if she happens to meet Brown, well, you know what to do.
Right.
Say, pal. Did you buy nobody a little drink? I sure need one. I ride pretty hard for a couple of days. Someday I'll get a pretty good job and I'll pay you back on it, if you will. Get together on.
Nah, go on, get out of here.
No, I just wanted to get a drink, is all.
Well, I'll teach you not to be so smart.
Just a minute.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Yeah? What's it your business?
Well, I'm making it my business.
Chicken that time.
Yeah, or maybe not all either.
Come on, sit down. I'll buy you a drink.
Thanks.
Yes, sir. What's your pleasure, gentlemen?
Bottle of seltzer for me and rye?
No. Scotch.
Sometime.
And when round up time is drawing nigh, a cowboy sings a lullaby.
Anything like that, somebody's going to get hurt.
Come on, foolish, you're going with me.
Why, son, nothing.
Never mind, get going.
All right, take another man.
boss ain't at home.
Well, it's you I wanted to see.
What's on your mind?
I'm interested in that picture.
That's funny. Brown said to me before he left to watch that picture. He said it was sure valuable.
Well, I want it. And I'm willing to pay for it.
Hey, wait a minute, mister. I'm honest folks. That is up to a certain point.
Sure you are. And I admire you for it. But there wouldn't be any harm if you sort of left me alone in this room for about 5 minutes.
I'd like to accommodate you, but I can't do that. Not while I'm here alone. Why, that would look kind of suspicious-like.
Well, you know, I could take it.
Better keep your hand with my gun, mister. I'm as honest as I might be, but I'm pretty fast on the draw.
All right. As long as you're open for a proposition, here's what we'll do.
Yeah, I'm sorry he didn't stay. Are you sure you don't know that fellow?
Why, of course. I've already told you.
And you didn't know when you came here that Jim Martin and his men got away with $500,000 worth of government bonds?
If I'd known that, do you think I would have come here?
No, I don't suppose you would. That's the reason why the best thing you can do is fill your tank full of gas and get right back home.
Back home? But you said that...
I know, but there's going to be a lot of trouble around here. People are going to get hurt or killed or sent to jail. There's no place for a girl.
Well, when I wanted to leave, you insisted I...
Yeah, but at that time, I thought...
That I knew something about the missing bond. Mm-hmm. Well, no matter what you think, I'm going to see this through.
All right, have it your own way.
Be persuaded after you give me a chunk of money.
You think they'd go through with it the way you planned?
Oh, absolutely.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Looking for ghosts?
Well, let's say, by the way, better get away from that window.
What's the matter?
If there is a ghost out there, you'll probably have a six-shooter and we'd make a fine target standing in front of that window. Even you ought to know better than that.
Then you think that...
I think...
He's coming back.
To your question. When the ghost drew us outside, they came in and grabbed it.
Well, maybe they'll let us alone now they've got what they want.
They haven't got what they want. And when they find it out, that's when the real fireworks are going to start.
Frame. There's a club that was in it.
Hmm.
Brown beat us to it.
We gotta do something quick. He won't waste much time uncovering the stuff.
Well, where is it? What did you find in there?
Not a thing. Brown found it first.
That's what you say.
Well, that's true.
That's right, Luke. Me and Slade got the picture just as we planned.
Yeah, just as you planned. I'm good enough to do the dirty work for this outfit, to do the fighting and take a beating. But when it comes to plans, I get double-crossed.
You ain't been double-crossed. As for your work, you've been paid for it. We don't pay you for what you know.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, I know plenty. And there's lots of folks would pay to hear it.
Don't do that.
That man that shot you.
Try hard, old boy. Tell me, who was he?
What's up, Slade?
Brown just shot Luke Green.
You see him do it?
Yeah.
Down the road about a quarter of a mile. Brown comes out of the wood and down Luke before he had a chance. I didn't have no gun, so I came to get help.
Let's go.
You don't think I killed this man, do you? He was shot from ambush.
That's the man, Sheriff. I saw him.
Oh, so you're the fellow that ran away from my place so fast the other day. I'm beginning to understand now.
This gun just been fired, yes, but it wasn't pointed toward that man.
We'll let the judge decide that.
Get on your horse, Brown.
You lock me up, Sheriff. I'm going to have a hard time proving my innocence.
You darn right you will. Come on, Brown.
Much of a head start.
Well, let's head for his place.
Why, don't be silly. He wouldn't go there.
Listen, that Martin girl's working with him. She'd know where to find him.
Maybe you're right. Let's go.
Have you seen anything of Mr. Brown?
No. But I wish he'd come back. I'm worried.
Worried, huh?
Yeah.
Well, he's been to work pitch and this and come out of it without any scratches on his hide.
What do you mean?
Why, you know that devil-may-care look of his.
You think he's one of Ben Martin's men? Well, I don't believe it. I don't know who he is or what he is, but I do think he's honest. Come in.
Where's Brown?
I don't know. He went into town. What do you want with him?
He's wanted for murder. He shot and killed Luke Green a couple of hours ago.
I don't believe it.
No? And maybe you'll tell us who Brown is and what he's doing around these parts.
I don't know why you're here, Miss Martin, but I think you're mixed up in this deal somehow. But we'll catch up with him. What do you know about this fellow Brown?
Not a thing. I'm just a hired help here. I never saw the man until the other day.
That's right, Sheriff. He came to this ranch looking for work before Brown came.
Well, I guess he's not here. But I'll leave one of my men to watch the place just in case he shows up. Come on, Ned. I've got some work for you to do.
Well, here's how it looks to me. If Brown took anything out of that picture frame, he ain't carrying around.
Well, if it's in that house, that Martin girl knows where.
Right. Lane, you take care of that guard.
Yeah.
In by searching you.
Wait a minute, Brainard. She don't know anything about that paper. I do.
He's lying, Brainard. He tricked us once.
No, I didn't. You got your picture. I saw Brown put a paper in his pocket. So I stole it. Sort of looked like a chart or plan. Thought maybe we might make a bargain.
Well, come across.
I reckon you men must be part of that old Ben Martin bunch.
Part of them? We're all of them. If you expect to see daylight again, you better hand over that paper.
Oh, sure. Sure, I'll go and fool him. Say you are. I guess you got a right to it.
Yeah. Now remember, just as soon as you see me go inside the house.
This is it. Listen, fellas. Big 10 yards further from the house, near the rocks down by the oak tree. Now this is it. All right, tie him up.
Nice shooting, Captain. These fellas just made a boat. They're the only ones left, the Dan Martin gang.
That's fine. When we dig that bullet out of Luke, that'll prove whose gun killed him. Now get up and get over there, you. Brainard, I might as well tell you that map you were so interested in is a fake. I made it myself. The bonds were hidden under the floor of this very room. I sent them to Washington this morning.
Who are you, anyway?
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Martin. Allow me to introduce Captain Lightning Bill Carson from the Federal Bureau of Investigation.
Lightning Bill Carson?
That's right.
Get going.
So you're Lightning Bill Carson. Well, why didn't you tell me?
Well, when I first came here, I thought you might be one of the Martin gang.
Oh, you did. Well, do you still think so?
You know, when I first met you, you were trying to buy this ranch.
Yes, but you own it now.
Well, you think you'd consider a half interest?
Well, but I don't think that I have...
It's a deal.
Why, nothing. I was just looking in.
So what do you want here?
Well, you see, I'm interested in abandoned farms and ranches and...
Well, this is a good ranch not to be interested in.
Well, I don't see that that's any of your business.
Lady, this place ain't a healthy one to hang around. It's haunted.
Well, I don't believe in ghosts.
That's just a polite way of telling you to get into your gas buggy and put as many miles between you and here as you can. Understand?
In trouble again, Miss Martin?
Who are you?
Brown's the name. Sam Brown. Now you clear out of here. You heard me.
Sudden, aren't you?
Huh? Oh, well, that's my name, Sudden Sam Brown.
Oh.
Who was that fella?
I don't know.
Well, he gave you some pretty good advice.
What do you mean?
About staying away from this place. It might be dangerous.
Well, I may as well tell you what I told him. I don't believe in ghosts.
Neither do I. But when a fella like Ben Martin dies the way he did, he's apt to leave a trail of danger behind him. Just bear that in mind, young lady.
Thank you. That must be it.
Must be what? What did you see him there?
Why, nothing. I was just looking in.
So what do you want here?
Well, you see, I'm interested in abandoned farms and ranches and...
Well, this is a good ranch not to be interested in.
Well, I don't see that that's any of your business.
Lady, this place ain't a healthy one to hang around. It's haunted.
Well, I don't believe in ghosts.
That's just a polite way of telling you to get into your gas buggy and put as many miles between you and here as you can. Understand?
In trouble again, Miss Martin?
Who are you?
Brown's the name. Sam Brown. Now you clear out of here. You heard me.
You're out of sudden, aren't you?
Huh? Well, that's my name, Sheldon Sam Brown.
Oh.
Who was that fellow?
I don't know.
Well, he gave you some pretty good advice.
What do you mean?
About staying away from this place.
Hasn't got a thing on him.
Looks like he was too smart for us, Brainard.
Yeah. I thought it was funny him wanting to hang on to them bonds.
Could he have sold them without us knowing it?
No, not a chance. The only time Martin's been alone since we stuck up the train is when he was in bed. Then he must have hidden them someplace around that ranch. Maybe you're right. Come on, let's get going.
Washout. I still think the bombs are in the house.
No, I've been over that place with a fine-tooth comb. The only thing I found was the map with the directions to dig here.
Yeah, it must be a phony.
Well, there's no use quitting till we find out.
Martin wouldn't bury the stuff that deep.
Oh, there's no telling what he'd do.
You boys digging for fish worms?
Oh, don't shoot, mister. I ain't no game warden. You can fish if you want to. I won't bother you.
Who are you?
Jack Benson. They call me Magpie. Silly name, ain't it?
What do you want?
The guns make me nervous. Thanks, pal. Looking for a job.
Anybody send you here?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, I don't want to tell.
I'm giving you just 2 seconds to talk. What are you doing here at this time of the night?
Listen, I was just down at that Martin place. They're both inside, Brown and the girl. And they're talking about that painting of old Ben that hangs on the wall. The girl said Ben wrote the picture was worth a lot of money. That's it. The picture. When you searched that house, did you look that picture over well?
No. I didn't see how they could hide anything in that.
Well, if he left any directions as to where he hid the bonds, that's just where he left them. Come on inside.
Go down and sound him out. You wait here and don't let anybody see you.
Hard feelings, Brown. Everything's fair in love and war.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about it.
You know, I meant to buy this place. You beat me to it.
Well, I was afraid of competition.
Would you care to sell? It's not a fair price.
Well,
name Brown?
Yes, I'm Brown.
I'm sure glad of that. I braced this fellow for a job and he turned me down. Sheriff said you want to hire a hand.
Well, I guess maybe I could use you. Go out to the house. I'll talk to you later.
Thanks, pal.
You were saying you'd like to buy this place?
Yeah. What'll you take for it?
Oh, about half a million.
Half a million?
Well, I figure I ought to get about that much out of it.
Oh, you mean you don't want to sell?
Well, not exactly. Not just yet, anyway. I want to see how things work out.
Bonds on it. He's up in there somewhere. Come on.
Hasn't got a thing on him.
Looks like he was too smart for us, Brainard.
Yeah. I thought it was funny him wanting to hang on to them bonds.
Could he have sold them without us knowing it?
No, not a chance. The only time Martin's been alone since we stuck up the train is when he was in bed. Then he must have hidden them someplace around that ranch.
Maybe you're right. Come on, let's get going.
Washout.
I still think the bombs are in the house.
No, I've been over that place with a fine-tooth comb. The only thing I found was the map with the directions to dig here.
Yeah, it must be a phony.
Well, there's no use quitting till we find out.
Well, I may as well tell you. You're right about my being related to Ben Martin. He was my uncle. But I didn't know anything about him. He wrote Mother, though, that that picture was very valuable.
That one? Doesn't look very valuable, does it?
No, I guess I made a fool of myself.
Well, now, maybe not, you know. Tell you what we could do. We could have it valued, and if you still want it, why, maybe we can make a deal.
Thank you. I guess I'd better go now. I left the car down the road.
I'll go along with you if you don't mind.
Thank you.
Well, what are you doing here at this time of the night?
Listen, I was just down at Martin place. They're both inside, Brown and the girl. And they're talking about that painting of old Ben that hangs on the wall. The girl said Ben wrote the picture was worth a lot of money.
That's it? The picture. When you searched that house, did you look that picture over well?
No. I didn't see how they could hide anything in that.
Well, if he left any directions as to where he hid the bonds, that's just where he left them. Come on inside. Go down and sound him out. You wait here and don't let anybody see you.
Hard feelings, Brown. Everything's fair in love and war.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about it.
You know, I meant to buy this place. You beat me to it.
Well, I was afraid of competition.
Would you, care to sell? Not a fair price.
Well...
and watch the girl. And if she happens to meet Brown, well, you know what to do.
Right.
Say, pal, could you buy an old buddy a little drink? I sure need one. I ride pretty hard for a couple of days. Someday I'll get a pretty good job and I'll pay you back on it, if you will. Get together on.
Nah, go on, get out of here.
Thanks.
Wise guy, eh?
Why, no, I just wanted to get a drink, that's all.
Well, I'll teach you not to be so smart.
Just a minute.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Yeah? What's it your business?
Well, I'm making it my business.
try that.
Looks like Jim picked the wrong chicken that time.
Yeah, or maybe not all either.
Come on, sit down. I'll buy you a drink.
Thanks.
Yes, sir. What's your pleasure, gentlemen?
Bottle of seltzer for me and rye?
No. Scotch.
Sometime.
And when round up time is drawing nigh, a cowboy sings a lullaby.
Thank you.
You say he called her Miss Martin?
Yeah.
Say, wonder if Martin could have told that girl where he hid those bonds. Say, maybe you've got something there, Slade. You should have held on to her.
Well, that fella Brown was too fast for me. I had my gun out, but he winged me before I could pull the trigger.
Well, there's no use crying over spilled milk. I'll hightail it into town and see if I can get an option on the Martin place from the sheriff. One of you keep an eye on that Martin girl.
Okay.
I'd like to accommodate you, Brown, but it's impossible.
Well, what about getting an option on the place for a couple of weeks?
No.
Suppose that paper told against it.
Too late for that now. Sale goes on as advertised tomorrow.
Well, in that case, there's nothing for me to do but try to bid it in, eh?
Oh, you won't have much competition. That ranch has sort of got a bad reputation.
I've heard about that. The ghost of Ben Martin, supposed to haunt it or something like that, isn't it?
Good morning, Miss Martin. We seem to be following each other around, don't we?
I don't think so.
Good afternoon, young lady.
Sheriff Long?
That's right. Sit down.
I'm interested in the Ben Martin Ranch.
Yeah? What about it?
Well, if the debt against it isn't too much, I'd like to pay it.
Well, you were the second one that wanted to do that today.
Who else wanted to? The man who just left here?
Mike, bye.
Well, I just about give you up. I didn't think you'd go to jail.
Well, I got here as quick as I could. What's been happening? Let's get under cover.
One of your grave diggers?
Yeah, he's a big moose of the outfit.
That's what I thought. Now, that Martin Ranch is going under the hammer tomorrow. You lay low till after that sale.
Oh, Brainard! Just
yeah?
A minute. I've got something in here to interest you.
Well, look, I'm in a hurry. I don't want to take much time.
Oh, my! Keep your hand away from that gun.
Now get up to your feet. Hand me that gun.
You can't get away with this.
Well, I seem to be.
All right, folks, we better get started.
Say, can't you hold off a minute, Sheriff? Brainard ain't here yet.
10 o'clock's the time, and that's what it is now. Sale goes on as advertised. Now, you all know this ranch, and those of you that don't have had plenty of time to look it over. Everything is included. Buildings, land, machinery, and livestock of any. Now, who's going to start the ball rolling?
Who's going to be the first bid?
$500. All right, anything to get underway. Now, who'll make it $1,000? What's the matter? You all tongue-tied? You know this ranch is worth at least $5,000. Come on, speak up.
$600.
$600 I'm bid. Now, who'll make it $700?
Seven.
$700 it is. I bid $700, now the $800. Who'll give me the $800? I hate to do this to you, Brainard, but you're apt to get in my way.
Brown's on it. He's up in there somewhere. Come on.
Hasn't got a thing on him.
Looks like he was too smart for us, Brainard.
Yeah. I thought it was funny him wanting to hang on to them bonds.
Could he have sold them without us knowing it?
No, not a chance. The only time Martin's been alone since we stuck up the train is when he was in bed.
Then he must have hidden them someplace around that ranch.
Maybe you're right. Come on, let's get going.
Washout. I still think the bombs are in the house.
No, I've been over that place with a fine-tooth comb. The only thing I found was the map with the directions to dig here.
Yeah, it must be a phony.
Well, there's no use quitting until we find out.
Anything like that, somebody's going to get hurt.
Come on, foolish, you're going with me.
Why, it's done nothing.
Never mind, get going.
killed myself.
Well, now, maybe not, you know. Tell her what we could do. We could have it valued, and if you still want it, why, maybe we can make a deal.
Thank you. I guess I'd better go now. I left the car down the road.
I'll go along with you, if you don't mind.
Thank you.
What are you doing here at this time of the night?
Listen, I was just down at that Martin place. They're both inside, Brown and the girl. And they're talking about that painting of old Ben that hangs on the wall. The girl said Ben wrote the picture was worth a lot of money.
That's it? The picture. When you searched that house, did you look that picture over well?
No. I didn't see how they could hide anything in that.
Well, if he left any directions as to where he hid the bonds, that's just where he left them. Come on inside. I'll go down and sound him out. You wait here and don't let anybody see you.
No hard feelings, Brown. Everything's fair in love and war.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about it.
You know, I meant to buy this place. You beat me to it.
Well, I was afraid of competition.
Would you, care to sell? At a fair price.
Well...
Name Brown?
Yes, I'm Brown.
I'm sure glad of that. I braced this fellow for a job and he turned me down. Sheriff said you want to hire a hand.
Well, I guess maybe I could use you. Go out to the house. I'll talk to you later.
Thanks, pal.